This week on my Working with Todoist episode, I'm going to show you how you can customize your Todoist. Now I'm going to do that by showing you how to do it using the desktop or web version, as well as the mobile version of Todoist, because you can customize each of those different things in slightly different ways. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips and tricks on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, without any further ado, let me take you into my demo account as well as my demo iPhone account, but don't worry, it works with Android just as well. And I'll show you how you can customize your very own Todoist. Right, first up, the start page, or as I like to call it, the home page, simply because home begins with H and H is the keyboard shortcut to get back to it. Now, what I mean is this is my start page. I've got my inbox up at the top and I've got my today's items underneath. If I go to my inbox here, and you can see I've only got one item. If I hit the H button, that's going to take me back to my personalized start page. So to do that, you just go into the settings, which is the gear icon here in the top right. Go to settings and general. And from there, you get the start page right here. And I've got mine set up as dashboard, which is a filter that I created, and we'll cover filters in a moment. But you can choose anything you like from here. So you've got the queries, which is the standard default queries that Todoist give you, which is today and upcoming. You can choose a specific project. So for those of you using the time sector system, for example, you may wish to start with this week. It's just an option. Another one, you can use your labels. Now, I personally don't use labels. This is my demo account, and I want to show you a quick idea that you can use for labels. And then we've got the filters right here. And I use filters for my own dashboard, which is why you can create these unique customized views. So I've got dashboard here, but I could start with my today's focus, which are the 10 tasks that I want to accomplish today. I could start with any of these, but for me, I have my dashboard because then it shows me my inbox at all times when I hit that H button. So that's the first one. That's create your very own start page. Now, the second one is to create filters that work for you. Now, I'm frequently asked about my filters. What are the filters that I use? And I understand why people are asking, because, you know, I often talk about my specific filters. The only thing is that these filters work for me. They might not necessarily work for you. And if you don't use the 2+8 prioritization system, then my filters are useless to you because they're not going to help you. If you do use the 2+8 prioritization system, then yes, this will probably work very well for you. So what I have as my three main filters that I use is today's objectives. Now, this essentially is my red flagged items for today. And when I do my weekly, when I do my daily planning, this is where I would generally start. I want to know what my objectives are. I should say I do actually do my planning the night before, but when I start the next day, this is where I go for my reminder. This is what's going to tell me what my objectives are for today. There's only ever going to be two items in here. It's a fantastic view to start the day with because it's not overwhelming. There's just two tasks, and it reminds me about exactly what it is I want to get done today. Then we've got today's focus. I should share, because I know people are gonna ask me, what is this? This is just a really simple filter. It is just today and P1. That's it, today and P1. That gives me my today's objectives, and that means anything that I've flagged with a red flag, P1 flag, and is due today. My next one is my today's focus. This is the one which, to me, is the most important flag of my view that I go into and spend most of my day in there. Now, at the moment, I don't have, I'm going to go into my today because I haven't got anything flagged. I'm just going to quickly flag some, do the invoices. Let's just flag a couple here so that you get the idea of what this will look like. And we'll flag this one, and we'll flag that one. These are not necessarily prioritized tasks, but now you can see I've got five items in here. Now, basically, this is anything that has a red, a blue, or an orange flag. Now, the reason why I have the red flag, the P1 in there as well as my today's objectives is simply because this is the view I'm going to spend most of the day in. My today's objectives, I check first thing in the morning. It's a reminder. It tells me what my objectives of the day is. I then switch to this one. It's like a little workflow that I have. I then switch to this one, and this is where I spend most of my day. I will be in this particular view right up till maybe 4, 5, or maybe 6 o'clock, and at which point then I will hit the H button, and that will take me straight to there. And all I will have then are my less important tasks left to do. So that's my today's focus. Today's focus, by the way, if you're interested in that one, the filter is today and not P4. Now, the not emblem, if you like, the not symbol is just the exclamation mark. So that will exclude anything that comes after the exclamation mark. So my filter query for this is today and not P4. That's the P4, the white flag, if you like. And another one that I actually have is my focused 10. Now, my focused 10 are the things that it used to be called the golden 10, for those of you who've been following me for a while. Now, essentially what that means is, and I'll show you, it'd be easier to explain from here. It is 2 days and not P4. So anything that's flagged for today or tomorrow. Now, the thing is, I go into this filter at the end of the day. So it hopefully there's very, very few items left in here. I should have completed them by the time I go into this. And what I'm making sure is that there's no more than 10 items in here. Now, if there's a lot less than 10, let's say I've only got, as in here, I've got one. So that means I can go, when I do my daily planning, I can go in and I can find other tasks that I can do to add to the list. Sometimes I look at it and there's 13 or 14 tasks in there, and I need to reduce that down to a maximum of 10. So it's a really good way of helping me to prioritize. Now, these are my filters. These work for me. It doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to work for everybody. It might not work for you. But for me, and particularly because I do practice the 2+8 prioritization system every single day, then I use these filters every single day. So that's the filters that I have set up. Now, I don't particularly use labels. Labels are not something that I use at all, but I've got a couple here because one of the areas that I do think that labels can be very, very useful are labels for people. Now, if you're working with a team of people, which I don't, but if you're working with a team of people, I can see the advantage of having labels for tasks that you want to talk to somebody about, maybe somebody in your team. So I've got RK here. RK is my wife. So these are a couple of things that I want to talk to my wife about, or these are a couple of things that I want to ask my wife to do. So I actually have a label. I don't in real life, but I could have a label for my wife. Let's imagine that Peter is my fitness instructor, and therefore I will have a label for Peter maybe, and to talk about next week's exercise schedule. Rosa could be a colleague, so discuss with Rosa plans for non-committed members. And maybe I've got one for the finance team because I need to ask them to chase any invoices, for example. But I would suggest that if you really like using labels, one of the most powerful labels you can use is to use labels for the people that you actually work with or come into contact with on a regular basis, because you're not necessarily going to meet them every single day. You might not meet them for maybe a couple of weeks, but some of these tasks may not be particularly urgent, but when you do see them, you've got a label that you can go in and actually talk to them about. Now, before we finish this episode, what I want to do is I want to show you how to create your start page on your mobile device. And I want to show you something that's called the Siri shortcuts. For those of you who are using an iPhone or an iOS device, an iPad, then Siri shortcuts are another way that you can personalize your Todoist. And I'm going to show you how to do that. So join me now when I move on to my iPhone. Okay, then on your iPhone, what you can do, or your iPad, you can actually set up a start page here too. What you do is go into settings, and you go into general, and as you'll see down here, the second item down the list, it says start page. So you can actually, as I've got here, dashboard, and I'm actually syncing the start page. So again, just like you had in the on the desktop version of Todoist or web version of Todoist, you've got your the queries that actually come up with Todoist as standard. Then you've got your projects, your labels, and then filters. As in, just like my desktop, I have my dashboard set up and I can use that one. Now I've got this as sync start page. Now what that means is this now syncs across all my devices. The start page on all my devices, my iPad, my laptop, and my iPhone, all begin with this start page. If I wanted to have a custom start page just for my mobile phone, I could turn off the sync start page and I could actually say, actually what I want on my phone is, I want my, let's go to my filters, I just want my today's focus, and I will set that up as my today's focus. So essentially what happens now is, as you can see on the mobile phone, there is no home button. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quit out of Todoist. I'm going to restart Todoist now. And as you can see, it immediately opens up in my today's focus. And the beauty of doing that is my today's focus is never going to have more than 10 tasks in there. So it's not going to be look an overwhelming list. So that's the first thing that you can do on your phone. Now, one more thing that I want to show you before we end this, which is to use Siri shortcuts. Now, for those of you using an iPhone or an iPad, you can use Siri shortcuts. Now, if you go back to settings, and we go down to the bottom from your settings menu, you'll see this one called Siri. Now you have a number of options here. First, you need to enable Siri. So you're gonna allow that to happen. So now Siri is enabled so that she will now listen to me. And what I'm looking for is, I want to be able to ask Siri to show me my today's focus list. So from wherever I am in my phone, all I need to do is ask Siri to show me my today's focus. What I need to do then is to go into Open Filter, and I'm going to click on today's focus. Now what happens here is Siri is going to say, when I say that word to engage Siri, all I have to do is say open today's focus. So to do that, all I need to do now is click add to Siri. I've actually already got that there, so it's already done. I can cancel that and I can come out. Now, before I do this, I want to ask you, if you have an iOS device sitting around your desk, in your phone, on your phone or anything like that, just turn it over to the opposite side, because I'm about to say that phrase, and if you don't do that, I'm going to engage your Siri to start doing this. So I'm giving you fair warning, turn off your Siris now, turn your phone over, close down your iPad, just shut the lid. And if you've got a HomePod, I don't know what to do because I don't have a HomePod and I don't know how to turn it off. Are you ready? I'm gonna say it right now. Hey Siri, open today's focus. And there you go. Siri opens up my today's focus. Actually, it doesn't because I'm in settings and I should have cleared that. Let me just go back and we'll do that one again. So again, make sure your Siri's turned off. Hey Siri, open today's focus. There you go. Now it's showing me my today's focus. The reason it didn't do that before is because I actually left my settings open, and I noticed the same thing happened when I was testing this. When my settings are open, it will go back to your settings. But that's another one, and you can do many, many more from that. You can actually choose whatever you want from the Siri. So you can open today, and you just have to say, well, open today, and it will give you, and then you just need to tap add to Siri, and then you're waking up the Siri commands. And you can actually go into Siri shortcuts on your iOS device and you can try and create. I say try because I've had so much fun failing at that one, but if you use the built-in ones, they are ready for you and they're so easy to set up. So there you go, those are just some of the things that you can use or do to customize your Todoist so that it works for you. I should point out before we finish, you can change the colors as well, but I'm hoping that you actually already know that. To change the colors, whether you're on the iMac, whether you're on a computer, a desktop version, just go to theme. You can change the theme to dark mode, which actually looks really good on a phone, and you can do quite a few things. Another thing that you can do, by the way, is the app icon. you can actually change the color of your app icon. Now, the ones with these little badges, these gold badges, they are the pro version. So if you have a premium account, you can use it. But for all the others, then you can use those. And there's some various different colors. And essentially, if I change it to orange now, so I've changed that, I come out of that. If I go out, you'll see that now Todoist is orange. Or I could actually go into here and I could change it to the dark icon because I'm using dark mode. And I come out and now Todoist is black. So there you go. That's just some of the things that you can do to actually customize your Todoist. I hope you found this episode useful. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. Now, I'd like to introduce you to a brand new way of managing your tasks. Now, this system is called the Time Sector System. It's designed to do away with your projects, to do away with your goals, or at least do away with them from your time management system, your to-do list manager, and instead focuses on when you are going to do the task. Now, the reason for this is from a research that I did for the whole of last year, figuring out why most people were really struggling with their tasks, getting their tasks done on a day-to-day basis. What I discovered was they were managing their tasks by project. And the biggest problem with managing tasks by project is, first of all, deciding whether a task is a project or not. Two or more tasks becomes a project, which means that you end up with a huge project list. And once you have a huge project list, just managing that list takes up an awesome amount of time. Time you could well better be spent actually doing the work, not organizing. The time sector method is designed to do away with all that processing so that the only decision you have to make is when are you going to do a task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, how urgent a task is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. So the whole clip, this, I have launched a brand new course that gives you the step-by-step approach of setting up the time sector method. It's a revolutionary course. It's designed for the 21st century, for all the inputs that we get today, all the emails, the Slack messages, and everything else that comes our way. It's designed to deal with that, to manage that, so you stay focused on what you have identified are your most important tasks for the day. I'd love to see you in the course. Full details of the course are in the show notes below. I'd love you to check it out. Join me in the course and let's take your productivity to a greater level than you've ever, ever imagined. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. I just wish you all a very, very productive week.